Hey Louis.
Hey Lou.
How are you?
Very good, you?
I'm good. Do you remember my Wilmhurst machine?
Your Wilmhurst machine, yeah, sure. Remind me how it works again?
So I can move charge from one side to the other side, and when the voltage got high enough, I got a spark. Look.
Okay.
There you go, sparks.
Neat.
So I can use this to charge up a capacitor.
A capacitor? Like this one right there?
Yep.
Okay, let me see what this is. You have a metal bucket, another metal bucket with a hook, and that, I guess, is a plastic bucket. Okay? So the two metals are not touching each other. There's a plastic in between. So we're going to charge this. All right, this is discharge, I'm assuming.
Mm-hmm.
I can... Oof, safe. All right, charge this here. Okay, so now you're connected, this plate connects to the bottom, the top is connected to the red, the bottom here is connected to the black, so let's charge it.
Here we go.
That's it?
Yep.
Okay, this is charged?
Yep.
So I guess I can test this. Both of these are conductor. Whoa, it was charged. Neat. Cool, that's a pretty nice capacitor.
Yeah, that's called a Leyden. That's one of the first invention of a capacitor.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I think it was in the city of Leyden in Belgium. Pretty neat. You know one thing about Leyden jars? That's pretty special to this kind of capacitor. I can undo it. I can take the capacitor and break it into its pieces and put it back, and it still will be charged.
What do you mean?
Let me show you, it's pretty cool. My discharge, gotta be safe. See, there was spark here. Well, but, all right, so charge it again. Okay, all right. This stuff is dangerous. Don't do this at home, people. Separate it. All right, that's the first metal bucket. Safe to touch by itself. Here's this next one. Also, all safe to touch. Now you can even touch these two. And let's put it back together now. Pretty neat, right?
Yeah.
This is really actually kind of tricky to understand this type of physics. So more, the important message, this is a capacitor, and you can charge a capacitor by moving charge on each metal plate, and then you can discharge a capacitor by connecting the two metal. And this is a really useful thing to do. Here's an ultra capacitor, a modern one. These look like batteries. They're not batteries. They're capacitors, and they've been charged. And so let me discharge them. Ready?
Whoa! Sparks!
Whoa! Okay, gotta be careful with capacitors. Okay, thank you.